Hi guys, this is Bhaskar Berry. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to cover the Apache Kafka, the installation process in this video, but in the later videos I'll be covering what is Kafka and core concepts of Kafka and testing the Kafka in your local systems. So as and when I do these videos, I request you guys to follow up and replicate the same thing in your missions and let me know if you face any issues so that I can help you with those queries regarding the Apache Kafka. Okay, let's start with the installation of the Kafka. But before starting the installations of Kafka, we need to have Java installed in your system. So I'm going to just check whether Java is installed in my system or not. To check the Java installed in, just click on this command Java version, so you get the versions if it's already installed in your system. So you can see here my system, there's already Java installed in this. So I'm just going to close that. And to install that, go to this website called kafka.apache.org. So once you go to this site, you can see the downloads here. Click on, I have just clicked on 2.10 here. And when you click on that, you get a new website, new site called this one. So I just click on this mirror downloads. You can see here it's got downloaded for me. Okay. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to extract to one of the folders this Kafka which I have downloaded here. So I'm going to cut it and paste it in one of the folders, saying that BDF. So once you have placed the Kafka folder in this, let us start the let me show you the zookeeper. This is a zookeeper properties files and this is a server.properties files. I'll explain what is the port numbers, everything in later point. Here is a 2181 for the default port number. You can change this along with the server.properties. So that port number will be binded to this Kafka here. It's 2181. So if you're working on Linux missions, you can use these shell scripts. Because I'm currently working on Windows mission, so I'm using this Windows here. So open a command prompt from this folder and start the zookeeper. Why I'm going to this is because this is two level folders below. So I'm going to this folder, Kafka. Config to attach that config file, I have something called zookeeper.properties here. So okay, execute this. So this zookeeper has been started. So let us start even Kafka server similarly. Okay. We have something called server.properties in that folder again. See here we have server.properties, so that's the one I'm going to give here. Okay, so execute this command. So you can see here the Kafka server has been started. So this is how you can work on this Kafka servers. Thank you for watching. Please do subscribe my YouTube channel. So in the next video I'm going to talk about Kafka's introductions and why we are using Kafka and for what purpose we are using Kafka, the log details, everything I'm going to take up in the next part. Please do subscribe my YouTube channel.